Today we're going to talk about inadequate public school funding and how it affects the students that have to go to these schools. So did you know that 6.6 million students from low-income families are affected every year by local and state funding? In 1965, the Elementary and Secondary Education Act was passed. It gave funding to districts to help assist in educating economically disadvantaged students. However, the Cleveland public school system is still weakening from this inadequate funding that they have going on. Efforts to improve education in Cleveland through school choice have tried to been made. Students were given vouchers where they could have the right to choose to go to a charter or private school. However, this takes funding away from the Cleveland public schools and puts it into these charter and private schools, again making inadequate funding happening. Over the last 6 weeks, I have been part of the PAR, Participation Action Research at Case Elementary School on East 40th Street. I got to hear and see firsthand from the students how inadequate funding affects them and the school and the learning environment they're in. The students felt that the environment at the school was disrespectful to them and their learning. Examples of this included the school had bathrooms with no stall doors, a small library with old books that had pages ripped out of them, and broken musical instruments, and a small computer lab for a K-8 school. Inadequate school funding is an issue in our school systems, and hopefully we can fix this one day.